नमस्कार मित्रांनो, तुमचं सर्वांचं या यूट्यूब चॅनल मध्ये स्वागत आहे। तर मित्रांनो, आज आपण शिकणार आहोत व्हॉट इज फार्मास्युटिकल लेजिस्लेशन। मित्रांनो, वेळ वाया न घालवता आपण आजच्या व्हिडिओला सुरुवात करूया। चला तर मग जाऊया मोबाईल स्क्रीन वरती।
द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस चॅप्टर दॅट इज नाउ आवर फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टंट चॅप्टर फार्मास्युटिकल लेजिस्लेशन इन इंडिया। जनरली लेजिस्लेशन मीन्स रिलेटेड विथ द लॉ। Why it is necessary to have certain laws related with the pharmaceutical production, related with the pharmaceutical things. Generally, as per the definition of pharmaceutical legislation, it is defined as it is a subdivision of forensic pharmacy which deal with the laws, rules, regulations, section and schedules related to the pharmaceutical products and their preparation. It also deals with the regulatory system and criminal justice system. And in general, that is first important chapter jo hai apla pharmaceutical legislation, tala explain kele gele ki kay hai pharmaceutical legislation, ka garaj padli, kai kayde asavet aushadhansathi suddha yachi ka garaj padli, tyachi kay history aahe, tyacha explanation apan ya chapter madhe ghenar aahot। मग काय असतं फार्मास्युटिकल लेजिस्लेशन की काय आहे? इट इज अ सब डिव्हिजन ऑफ फॉरेन्सिक फार्मसी। ठीक आहे, हे कायद्याचं एक सब डिव्हिजन। मग काय रिलेट, कशाशी रिलेटेड आहे? दॅट इज डील्स विथ द लॉज, काय काय नियम आहेत, काय काय कायदे आहेत, काय रेग्युलेशन आहे, कसं ड्रग्ज आणि त्यांचे प्रोडक्ट आपल्याला विकायचे आहेत, ठेवायचे आहेत, ऑल दिस एव्हरीथिंग नॉलेज रिलेटेड विथ दिस दॅट इज इन्वॉल्व ऑर दॅट इज एक्सप्लेन इन केस ऑफ फार्मास्युटिकल लेजिस्लेशन। Generally, jurisprudence or that is word PJ is generally related, derived from the Latin word juris means that is law and prudentia means wisdom, knowledge or philosophy or science means laws and knowledge or laws and wisdom, laws and philosophy. Generally, in short, the PJ is called as, pharmaceutical jurisprudence is called as laws of wisdom, laws of knowledge or laws of philosophy or science of laws here itself. That is legislation. Generally, law intends for, why it is necessary to have legislation? Kaya asto kayda? Kashasati garaj ahe tyachi? That is law intends for regulation and control of various aspects of life. These aspects may be, might be economical, social or political. That is laws intended for regulation. Kashasati kelela asto kayda? Ki vegvegle je aspects of life che. काही अस्पेक्ट सोशल असू शकतात, काही इकॉनॉमिकल असू शकतात, काही पॉलिटिकल्स असू शकतात। फॉर एक्झाम्पल, सोशल म्हणजे कोणाला त्रास होत असेल तर त्याला आपण कुठपर्यंत औषध द्यायचे आहेत, इकॉनॉमिकल असेल तर कितीपर्यंत औषध आपण त्याला कमीत कमी किमतीत देऊ शकतो, किती औषध देणं गरजेचं आहे, किती औषध मेडिकलमध्ये ठेवणं इसेन्शियल, मीन्स ऑल दीज थिंग्स दॅट इज कम अंडर द टर्म ऑफ लेजिस्लेशन। Pharmaceutical legislation is a mixed legislation, means overlapping covers both economic as well as social aspect of life. As the pharmaceutical legislation hai te kay asta ki economical, financially related suddha hai, and second thing that is associated with the social life. So generally the main objective of this chapter, that is already I have stated that generally whenever you are dealing with the pharmaceutical jurisprudence, you are having the explanation that is it is associated with the object. So main object of formulation of pharmaceutical legislation, that is important one, to ensure the patient that receives drugs of required quality, tested, evaluated and safety as well as efficacy for their intended use. मीन्स पेशंटला अशा काही औषधे अवेलेबल करून द्यायच्या की ज्या की टेस्टेड आहेत, ज्या की इव्हॅल्युएटेड आहेत आणि ज्या की सेफ आहेत, जनरली ज्या त्रास कुठलाही होत नाही। फार्मास्युटिकल लेजिस्लेशन इज असोशिएटेड विथ द हेल्थ ऑफ सोसायटी। कसं हे स्टार्ट झालं. इन 1811 द फर्स्ट केमिस्ट शॉप ओपन बाय द मिस्टर बाथगेट हू केम टू इंडिया विथ द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इन कलकत्ता. कसं सुरू झाला कायदा, कुठले कुठले रूल्स होते, कसं फर्स्ट केमिस्ट शॉप आपल्या भारतात चालू झालं, त्याचं एक्सप्लेनेशन की 1811 काय होतं की खूप पूर्वी आपल्या इथे मेनली आवर इंडिया इज रिलेटेड विथ अ रिच हेरिटेज ऑफ व्हेरियस प्लांट्स अँड आवर एम्फसायझेस डिपेंड मेडिसिन वी आर ऑब्टेनिंग फ्रॉम द व्हेरियस सोर्सेस जनरली फ्रॉम द नॅचरल सोर्सेस इन दॅट केसेस जनरली दॅट इज फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टंट दॅट इज mainly our medicine based on the ayurvedic aspect. After that completion or utilization of ayurveda, we are having the delivering the various medicines. Regarding the allopathy system, how it is started, that is explained in case of the origin of legislation in India. In 1811 first chemist shop opened by Mr. Bathgate, who came to India with East India Company in Calcutta. In 1910, they have started to manufacture tincture and pure spirits. In 1811, the first shop opened. Who opened the first shop? That is Mr. Bathgate. He came from the East India Company. And where it is open first chemist shop? It is open at Calcutta here itself. What it manufactures? Generally it manufactures tincture and spirits. In 1821, another manufacturing unit started by the Smith Stain Street and Company, who started to manufacture apothecaries manufacturing in 1918. In 1901, Bengal Chemical and Pharmaceutical Works, a small factory, was started in Calcutta by Acharya Praful Chandra Roy. In 1901, the first pharmaceutical work, a small factory, started in Calcutta by Acharya P.C. Roy here itself. In 1903, Professor T.K. Gajjar opened small factory at Parad for development of pharmaceutical units in an alembic chemicals. These units were not sufficient till that these various units are started to manufacture some tinctures, some apothecary system based manufacturing. Till then, these units were not sufficient to fulfill the needs, demands of Indian. So, the most of medicine were being imported from the various countries in India, mainly from the UK, France and Germany. In First World War, the need was improved because of due to the First World War, the requirement, demand of this drug is increasing and demand of indigenous drug was also improved. Competition becomes so that various these countries, UK, France, Germany, they are competing to supply to complete the demands of Indian during of medicine during the First World War. Competition leads to unhealthy and undemarked flood with inferior and substandard, even harmful drugs are supplied during the First World War to the Indian by these various countries which are being imported, which are going to be import various medicines in India here itself. So, generally, it is necessary to have to control these various inferior qualities drug should not become harmful to the health of public, so that there is Indian government has appointed a committee which control over the quality of this drug which is supplied to the Indian. This committee is also known as Drug Enquiry Committee, and which is appointed in 1931 by the Indian government, and Mr. Arun Chopra is associated as a member of this committee. It is also called as DEC, Drug Enquiry Committee, or Chopra Committee here itself. The committee was asked, what is the main function, why this committee is formulated? Generally, the committee has having the responsibility, having control over these various inferior quality drug which is supplied to Indian. The committee was asked to make inquiries in the said matter and then to make recommendation for smooth control and manufacture and import and distribution of sell drugs in respect of public health. Means that committee has required to control import, manufacture, distribution and sale of drug according to the standard. What will be the recommendation? How this committee works? Near about 19 different recommendation was submitted by this committee so as to regulate the medicine which is received to the Indian people during the First World War should be of standard quality. Various recommendation this committee has committed. Generally, the main three recommendation of this drug inquiry committee, that is first, formation of Central Pharmacy Council and State Pharmacy Council, which would look after the education and training of professionals. Councils would maintain the register containing name and address of the registered pharmacist. So how the work of this committee, that is first important recommendation this committee suggested, which is this committee is formulated under the chairmanship of Dr. Arun Chopra and has given in 1931, Arun Chopra has given the various recommendation to Indian government so as to run the legislation related with the pharmaceutical products in India, where the first important resignation to control this aspect of pharmaceutical manufacturing, import, distribution, sale of drug, it is necessary to made some committees which control over this profession, and by formulating the committees of Pharmacy Council of India as well as State Pharmacy Council has recommended by this committee. The second important recommendation, the creation of drug control machineries at the center and branches in all states. Okay, and how this control of production of drug, how this production should be increased so that for the creation of drug control machineries, departments in various branches of states are essential. And next important, whatever the drug prepared, is it evaluated for the safety? For evaluation of safety and efficacy of drug, it is necessary to have a well-equipped lab, which is considered as an establishment of third important recommendation of this Chopra committee or this drug inquiry committee, is that establishment of well-equipped central drug laboratory with competent staff and experts for sufficient and speedy work of drug control department as well as small laboratories will work under this, and so that the control of legislation so as to run smoothly regulation should be possible. Generally, after recommendation of this committee, the drug bill was approved. Because of the reluctant approach of government to orders, implantation of recommendation of DEC public pressurized the government ultimately, so that in 1931 the DEC committee was formulated, and in 1937 they import a drug bill was introduced in legislation assembly to control the import of drug. Mainly the constitution of this drug bill is for the important work, that is to control the import of drugs here itself. However, For the drug bill also explained, where the manufacture, sale and distribution of drug was not included in bill, but only the import of drug is included in bill. The committee forces the government to include all these aspects. Generally, whenever first in 1937, when drug bill was prepared, generally drug bill deals with the explanation with the various laws, with the various regulation which are related only with the import of drugs, and so that generally the distribution, sale, manufacturing, these things are not included under the legislation in case of drug bill. And so that this committee pressurized the government to include the manufacturing, sale and distribution in the bill. And so that due to the force of committee, government decided to include all these aspects. And in 1940, after 3 years, this drug bill was again introduced in assembly, and where it includes all these aspects, that is import, manufacturing, sale and distribution of drug. It came into a force as a Drug Act 1940. Later, it is amended with the time to time explanation related with the drug, cosmetic, Ayurvedic and Unani and homeopathic system. The present Drug Cosmetic Act, that is import to control, manufacture, distribution and sale of drug, central government made various rules regarding in 1945, and from time to time this act is started. After preparation of drug bill, after preparation of Drug and Cosmetic Act, other important act is also constituted so as to run the legislation related with the pharmaceutical aspects in India. And for example, this various act, according to the recommendation of Drug Inquiry Committee, that is Pharmacy Act 1948, Drug and Magic Remedies Act 1954, Medicinal.
तर मित्रांनो, आपला आजचा व्हिडिओ इथे संपलाय. जर तुम्हाला व्हिडिओ आवडला असेल तर व्हिडिओला लाईक, शेअर, कमेंट करायला विसरू नका, आणि त्याचबरोबर चॅनलला सबस्क्राइब करायला पण विसरू नका. आपण लवकरच भेटू नवीन टॉपिक मध्ये. तोपर्यंत नमस्कार.